Let's go segment two. Let's go to must-see TV, Cedric. And as I mentioned a little bit ago, we're in the middle of the NBA playoffs. Lots of great stuff going on, but there's already one team on to the conference finals. That's the Milwaukee Bucks, and one Giannis Antetokounmpo leading them.
Say that one more time.
Yeah, no, I'm not going to risk it, but
we
know him as the Greek Freak, and he is amazing, Cedric. Milwaukee to the Eastern Conference Finals. What a great story.
You know what? And probably still the most overlooked team in the playoffs. We don't get to see him that much on television. You know, Golden State and the Boston Celtics and the Houston Rockets, they get more pub than the Milwaukee Bucks. But when I tell you that's a squad and Giannis is leading the way, Eric Bledsoe, the point guard, is great. Chris Middleton, the former Aggie, doing work. Yeah. They just got Malcolm Brogdon back. They are poised to come out of the East. They don't want to listen to the people that believe that it's all about Kawhi Leonard and the Toronto Raptors. No, I think Milwaukee has an excellent chance because they have the best player in the playoffs right now. He is playing otherworldly basketball, getting it done old school fashion, a big guy taking it to the rack, dunking, baby hooks, and he can shoot an occasional three.
Yeah.
When he starts knocking on those threes in regularity, look out. We're talking about an all-time great.
You know, that Bucks squad sort of makes me think about Thunder teams of yesteryear when they were young and youthful and having fun. And, you know, it's really, I mean, you mentioned Chris Middleton, Cedric, and he's great, but he's kind of an unsung second star to Giannis. So, I mean, really a great collection of talent. You know, they get a chance to now cool their heels a little bit, wait for an opponent to come out of that other Eastern Conference semifinal. You know, I don't know if I think they're, even with Kevin Durant's injury, and we'll talk about that in a second, I don't know if they can beat the Warriors if they get to that point, but man, they're playing great ball. They beat a Boston Celtics team that had, you know, designs on getting not only to the Eastern Conference Finals, but potentially, you know, to the finals, winning the whole thing. They're out after, you know, one series victory in these playoffs. So impressive, impressive stuff by the Bucks. And I mentioned Durant, said we've got to talk about this. You mentioned Giannis as the best player in the playoffs. Until Kevin Durant gets hurt in game five of that Western Conference semifinal, he was playing lights out. But now they're saying it's a strain of that leg, but some people were thinking it might be as severe as an Achilles tear. That changes things. Now, it changes the Warriors back to like the 2016 Warriors, and we know how good they were, but still, being without Kevin Durant, potentially a game changer in these playoffs.
Big time game changer. Kevin Durant, if he's unable to go, the Golden State Warriors are not going to win the championship, and I'm going to tell you why. You mentioned the 2016 Golden State Warriors. That team was younger than this team and deeper than this team. This team has Sean Livingston coming off the bench. He's banged up and he's not as good as he used to be. DeMarcus Cousins tearing his quad has really hurt the depth. Andrew Bogut hasn't been playing that much. They don't trust him coming out on screens against these Rocket guards. At one point, the Rockets had five guards on the court: Chris Paul, James Harden, Aaron Gordon, Gerald Green, and PJ Tucker. They had five perimeter guys out there at once. They can go small with the best of them, Golden State. I really think the Houston Rockets let a huge opportunity get away on Wednesday night because they could have gone up 3-2, needing to just win one of two. Now they got a whole serve at the house on Friday night. I'll be in Houston for that. I've got the Choke City column ready to go if they don't close this thing out in seven. So they had a shot. Durant, I don't think, is going to play again in this series. If it's an Achilles, he's done.
Right.
If it's a calf strain and they survive this series, maybe, just maybe, he comes back. for the Western Conference Finals.
Well, what you said is, I think, is right, Cedric. I thought, you know, after his injury, that became such an opportunity for the Rockets to win at Golden State, to really swing the momentum going home, and the Warriors suddenly thinking, we got to win the next two, including what you would expect to be a highly charged atmosphere in Houston for Game 6. Now the Rockets, you know, need to survive, need to win the next two to win this series. You know, obviously, I do think, you know, it's going to be a challenge for the Rockets, but as much as anything, you know, obviously, everybody talks about the Warriors' offense, but last night, I thought when the Warriors were at their best, when they put on that run in the first half and looked like they were going to go and hide against the Rockets, they were playing outstanding defense. I mean, the Rockets couldn't find a passing lane, couldn't find a driving lane. They went a very long time without scoring. Obviously, the Warriors can score in bunches, and they did during that stretch, but it was really about the defense. And, you know, obviously Durant's part of that, his length on the perimeter. He makes things difficult, you know, even if he's not sort of an elite level defender. When he locks in, he can still change the game. But I think moving forward, the Warriors are going to have to lean on that as much as any time in these playoffs because, you know, if Steph isn't hitting shots, we've seen him struggle. If Klay can't carry the load, if they don't have the shooting that they did in those younger years. Cedric, great point about how those 16 Warriors, it was a lot of the same personnel, but a different time in their lives. They don't have that shooting. They got to be better defensively. So it's going to be really interesting to see what happens in Game 6 as this series points to potentially going a full seven.